हेलो दोस्तों, तो सब्सक्राइब कीजिए हमारे आस्क डॉक्टर मक्कर चैनल को और बेल आइकन को भी प्रेस कीजिए ताकि आप देख सकें हमारी लेटेस्ट वीडियोस सबसे पहले।
सर्विकल स्पॉन्डिलोसिस विद द इंक्रीज इन नंबर ऑफ प्रोफेशनल्स हु सिट फॉर आवर्स टुगेदर डूइंग डेस्क वर्क और सिटिंग फॉर आवर्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ द कंप्यूटर एंड कॉल सेंटर जॉब्स विच रिक्वायर्स कंटिन्यूअस सिटिंग इन वन पोस्चर. The number of people suffering with cervical spondylosis is on the rise. Cervical spondylosis is a wear and tear of the vertebrae and discs in the neck. It is a common cause of neck pain. The neck, termed as cervical, means a constricted part of body or organ. Long necks are believed to be beautiful. The neck has its own worth in having the cervical spine, spinal nerves, blood vessels, thyroid gland, food tube, oesophagus, wind tube, trachea, voice box, vocal cord, and muscles to move the head. In this golden age, the neck is often rewarded with a chain or necklace for beauty. Acupuncture and reflexology finds health points in favor of having a chain around the neck, like a ring on the finger. Neck is one of the most important parts of the body. Since it holds the head, which is the brain, it is the condensed pathway of the nerves, which emerge from the brain, to supply the parts of the body, and blood vessels from the heart, to supply the brain. It gives free movement to the head, to look around by remaining as unfused spine. Cervical spondylosis is a common degenerative joint disease that is due to aging and time-related wear and tear on the cervical vertebrae, bones, of the neck. The deterioration of cervical spondylosis also affects the cartilage, a slippery substance that helps bones to move easily, and the cervical discs, which are pillow-like tissues that allow cushion movement of the neck. Cervical spondylosis can lead to abnormal growths, bone spurs, on the cervical vertebrae, the vertebral column or spine. The cervical or neck spine is made up of small circular bones, vertebrae, stacked on top of each other. Between each vertebrae is an intervertebral disc, which acts like a shock absorber and allows flexibility of the spine. Muscles and ligaments run between and are attached to the vertebrae. Nerves from the spinal cord pass between the vertebrae, going to the shoulder, neck, arm, and upper chest. Cervical spondylosis. To an extent, we all develop a degree of degeneration in the vertebrae and discs as we become older. However, cervical spondylosis is a term used if the degree of degeneration is more severe and causes more symptoms than is expected for a given age. As the discs degenerate, over many years they become thinner. Sometimes the adjacent vertebrae develop small, rough areas of bone on their edges. The nearby muscles, ligaments, and nerves may become irritated by these degenerative changes, which can cause troublesome symptoms. If you are around the age of 40 or above and suffering from neck pain, there are good enough chances that the pain in your neck could be cervical spondylosis. Although this disorder can start early, but it usually appears around the age of 40. Although cervical spondylosis affects both sexes equally, men tend to develop it at an earlier age than women. Cervical spondylosis is a disorder of the neck spine, where the vertebrae, bones in the neck, and the discs, cushions between the vertebrae, start degenerating. This is also known as cervical osteoarthritis. Causes of neck pain and cervical spondylosis. Bone spurs. Bone spurs or osteophytes are tiny growths on the surface of the bone, caused by degeneration of the bony tissues. Dehydrated spinal discs. Spinal discs are thick, pad-like cushions that absorb the shock while walking, running, of lifting, twisting, and other activities. In the central portion of the disc, there are gel-like materials which can dry out over time. Injury. Any injury to the neck can impact on the spinal disc and spinal nerve. Ligament stiffness. The ligament that connect the spinal bones to each other can become stiffer over time, which affects the neck movement and makes the neck feel tight. Overuse of neck. Some occupation that puts extra pressure on the neck portion, like repetitive bending and bowing like in construction work, that causes wear and tear of neck ligament and put bad impact on the spinal disc. It can be a cause for chronic neck pain. Sleeping with the neck at an awkward position. If your pillow is too high, that may develop neck pain due to pressure buildup on the ligaments and disc and spinal nerve. Whiplash. Forceful, rapid back and forth movement of the neck is called whiplash injury. Generally occurred if suddenly you break your car. Your head move in a jerk backward and then beat on steering forward. Poor posture. Repetitive motions. Sports injury. Imagine a 16-year-old kid who's never had back pain or joint pain ever before. Then consider a normal 50-year-old who already has some of these age-related changes in their spine, but also doesn't have any significant pain. Now imagine that one day the 16-year-old kid wakes up in the 50-year-old's body. Suddenly he would hurt all over the place. This is because his brain didn't have those 30-odd years to adapt to the slow and steady changes that happen to the body. The brain is an amazing organ that adapts to new information extremely quickly. But in order to learn and adapt well to new information, we need good sleep, regular exercise, and a positive attitude. Just like what kids need to excel in school. As long as we give our brains these key ingredients, we can adapt to the normal age process and extinguish the signals coming from our spine. This is why the vast majority of people with degenerative disc disease or facet joint hypertrophy do not experience any cervical pain. So we looked at what normally happens to our spines as we age, and how our brain adapts to this process to prevent pain. What about when we do have cervical pain? What's going on there? How cervical develop more these days? Overuse in texting. Overuse in typing. Watching too much TV. iPad. Mobile. Common symptoms of cervical spondylosis. The major symptoms of cervical spondylosis are stiffness in the muscles of the neck and shoulder region. The pain and stiffness could be confined to the neck alone. There could be radiation of the pain from the neck to the right hand. There could be radiation of the pain from the neck to the left hand. There could be radiation of the pain from the neck to the back of the head. There could be giddiness associated with pain and stiffness. There could be only pain in the upper arm. There could be numbness in the tips of the fingers. These above symptoms could all suggest that you could be suffering from a condition known as cervical spondylosis. One of the major distinctions in our office is that we don't treat symptoms. We do not treat conditions. We create a treatment plan for you to address the underlying problem in your disc that is causing your pain and other symptoms. Now let's talk about the anatomy of the spinal disc. The healthy spinal disc is 86% water and needs water. oxygen, and nutrients to continue to survive. A unique feature of the spinal disc is that it is avascular, without blood, which is a fancy word. That means it does not have a direct blood supply. The only way the disc gets the water, oxygen and nutrients, the circulation, that it needs to survive, is by a very specific mechanism called the pump mechanism of disc nutrition. This mechanism works as we move, and works like a pump. If you injure the disc, the pump mechanism does not work properly, and over time will cause bulging discs, herniated discs, and degenerative disc disease, and, possibly, spinal stenosis. So the main problem causing your pain and symptoms is the failure of the pump mechanism. Now let's say we have a generic water pump, providing water to a plant. If one day that pump fails, it will cause a decrease in circulation to that plant. Well, what happens to any type of tissue, whether it be plant, animal, or human tissue, if it loses circulation? Exactly. It will cause the tissue to become weak, and eventually die. This is exactly what is happening in your spinal discs. The pump mechanisms are no longer working, and the disc needs circulation to be able to heal and repair. The treatment that we provide in our office will fix your pump mechanism that is not working in your injured spinal discs. So you have a decision to make. You can either continue to treat the symptoms of your serious spinal discs, which has not worked up to this point, or you can finally do something to fix the underlying cause of your disc problems. In very advanced cases of structural damage like a badly deformed spine, cervical spondylosis untreated leads to stiffness pain, tiredness in spine, spondylitis, spondylosis, increased pressure on spinal cord. Homeopathy treatment. Homeopathy treatment heals the injured nerves, helps to keep the spinal disc healthy, support the ligaments and muscles, helps to dissolve the bone spurs, relieve the pain, offers a long-lasting cure. Homeopathy has a very promising role in the treatment of cervical spondylosis, as well as in cervical radiculopathy. The long-term results of homeopathy are very encouraging. Scope of homeopathy treatment in neck pain and cervical spondylosis. As it is told before, that the pain commonly arises from suppression or irritation of the spinal nerves that comes out from spinal cord. So the treatment should be targeted. How to decompress the nerve portion and to heal the injured nerves. The compressions of nerves are generally caused by the muscles and ligaments present around the area. If any muscles get overstressed, that may put extra pressure to the concerned spinal nerve, and in the course of time there will be pain on that portion. Similarly, if there is any pressure effect of the concerned ligaments to the spinal nerves, that can also cause pain. There are other factors that are also responsible for generating of pain. The development of tiny bony growths over the body of vertebral bones that occurs in the aging process called osteophytes can sometimes irritate the spinal nerves and causes pain. The other reason of neck pain is due to the compression of intervertebral disc to the concerned spinal nerve. The disc do compress the spinal nerve in two causes. One, either due to the overstress that causes the disc to displace its position from the normal place to forward or backward side and press the spinal nerve. Two, if the disc's internal content, which is very soft jelly-like content, get dry, and that sometimes comes out like a bulge and press the spinal nerve. It is commonly found in aging process or prolonged dehydration condition. Homeopathy treatment in this case is very helpful. In the term of reducing the stress of the muscles and ligaments. And thus helps to reduce the inflammation of the muscles if persist by overstress. And also support the muscles and strengthen the muscles from becoming overstress. The pains are relieved within a short period of treatment by the specified homeopathic medicines. Besides to relieve the pain, it also helps to give a long-term curative effect by healing the damaging nerves caused by the muscles or ligaments or disc. The vertebrae are held by the muscles. If there is any undue pressure, that causes the vertebra more pulled in or pulled out, and eventually put effect on the intervertebral disc. The homeopathy medicines are acting to give strength to the muscles and heal up the injured nerve tissues, and thus give a long-term cure. Besides homeopathy treatment, it is too advised to avoid those triggers that give more pressure to muscles or ligaments. The homeopathy medicines are selected to treat the ailment by the totality of symptoms of the patient. Like other medical science, homeopathy does not have any specific medicine for any specific disease. The homeopathy medicines are selected as per the symptoms basis. And that depends how the doctor is taking the case history. More minutely and homeopathic way. Some patient tells that they have taken homeopathy treatment in past, but have not experienced any result. Here I would like to say that homeopathy did not give result. Because of the medicines may not be most similar to the totality of symptoms of the patient. Or there is some pathological obstruction that preventing further curative process. So it is highly required to take the case history properly in homeopathic way and to repertories for finding out the most similimum for the case. Remember, homeopathy primarily is symptom-based system of medicine. The medicine is determined by individual symptoms along with medication. We need to realize the importance of prevention of disease by lifestyle changes and diet management, in which Dr. Makkar helps you out of this. Dr. Makkar provide tailored prescription according to symptom similarity, not providing ready-made prescription. So chances of success higher when carefully case taking given by patient. Amp, taken by Dr. Makkar. The results of Dr. Makkar homeopathy in managing cervical spondylitis or spondylosis will be marvelous and dramatic compared to other doctors in same system of medicines or allopathic medicines. You can easily avoid surgical interventions.